Christmas time, here are a few things we need to highlight this week to keep you in the know regarding our ministry. On behalf of our senior pastor, Reverend Dr. Gerald Folsom, and First Lady Joyce Folsom, we welcome you. We are so grateful you are here, whether you are joining us in our virtual sanctuary or joining us in person. Mark your calendar for the 4th Quarterly Conference on Thursday, March 7th at 7 o'clock p.m. in person here at Greater Mount Nebo with Presiding Elder Weaver. The Men's Ministry, in partnership with Emmanuel Health Foundation Incorporated, will host a prostate cancer seminar on Saturday, February 24th from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. here at Greater Mount Nebo. We invite men to learn about signs, symptoms, and treatments for this disease. Women are also invited to gain tips to support their partners and family members. This is a free event. We need you to register to have an accurate count for lunch. Register now at bit.ly/GMNeboSeminar2024 or scan the QR code. Get ready for HBCU Sunday on February 25th during our 10 a.m. worship service. Our guest preacher is Reverend Dr. Lee P. Washington, Pastor Emeritus of Reed Temple AME Church. Wear your HBCU paraphernalia. Our bookstore's February sale is 50% off a second item of equal or lesser value. All calendars are 50% off while supplies last. Visit immediately after worship service. Our SALT ministry is sponsoring an event to see the production of Daniel at the Sight and Sound Theater on May 2nd, 2024. The cost is $225 per person. Cash and or money order are accepted. Pay after the 10 a.m. worship service in the Welcome Center. For more details, email us at churchoffice@gmnebo.org. Are you ready to experience God's living water? Do you desire to be baptized? This is open to everyone, members, and those not quite ready to join our kingdom family. We are ready to receive you to prepare. To sign up, please email churchoffice@gmnebo.org or call 301-249-7545. Make sure you like, follow, subscribe, and tag us to Greater Mount Nebo's official social media accounts at GMNebo AME on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, X, formerly known as Twitter, and TikTok. If you have not received Message from the Mount, our weekly email about our ministry and all opportunity to serve, in your inbox after checking your spam box, please email social@gmnebo.org. We have some exciting news. We want to make sure you never miss an important message from our church. If you have not been receiving text messages, text the Mount to 301-485-5313 to be added. Everyone is invited to our virtual church school every Sunday at 8:15 a.m. The winter quarters theme, Faith That Pleases God. February's theme, The Righteous Live by Faith. Please make a note of our updated Bible study schedule. On Tuesdays, Pastor Bible Study at 7 o'clock p.m., Wednesdays at 12 noon, along with Women's Bible Study at 7 p.m. We also have Thursday evening Men's Bible Study at 7:30 p.m. For the Zoom information for church school and any of these Bible studies, email christianed@gmnebo.org. Get ready for Thursday on the Mount. Pastor Folsom will be teaching live on Facebook and Zoom every Thursday at 12 noon. Join us and spread the word. Email social@gmnebo.org for the Zoom passcode. Join our prayer line for a short devotional message, prayer, and fellowship every Monday through Saturday at 6 a.m. and again at 1 p.m. Dial 605-468-8013. Access code 372536 #. It will definitely bless your day. If you missed Sunday's worship service or would like to rewatch it anytime, visit our Facebook page, YouTube channel, and our website at gmnebo.org. It's time to give. Sow a seed into our great ministry. Here are the ways. Text GIVE to 301-246-8816. Use Cash App, $GMNebo. Indicate your full name, envelope number, and giving destination. Visit our website at gmnebo.org and click Give. You can also mail your check or bring it to our drop box at 1001 Old Mitchellville Road, Bowie, Maryland 20716. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, family. Praise the Lord, greater Mount Nebo.
Hallelujah.
Good morning. I was glad when they said unto me, it's time to go to the house of the Lord.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Morning. We're going to do a corporate praise.
Worthy, worthy, for he is. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sometimes it is a good reminder for us to recognize that God is good. Sometimes it is a good reminder for us to think back on what God has done for us and what God is doing for us. And so because of that, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. There we go. For a day in thy courts are better than 1,000. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good. Blessed are they that dwell in thy house, Lord, for I have loved thy habitation, the place where God's honor dwells. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. You are my strength and my redeemer. O sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. All the earth sing his praises. And this morning, as we continue to celebrate the history of African Americans during this Black History, morning is the Black National Anthem. Lift every voice.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the lifting stars. Let us resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith and the fire.
Let us go to where we met thee. Thank you.
That you have done. In our nation, in our world, God, we God, you have kept us as a people, God. God, you have us of your grace and your mercy. You see, God, you have allowed us a willing people, God, in this sanctuary called Greater Mount Nebo African Methodist Episcopal Church. God, we say thank you.
Thank you, Lord God.
God, we say thank you for your grace. Allowed us to wake up this morning, God, with the activity of our limbs, God. God, with breath in our body, God. Thank you, dear God, because every moment that we breathe, God, we are able. Jesus. We are able, God, to give your name the glory. God, every time we lift our hands, we are able to say thank you. God, every time we blink our eyes, God, God, we are giving your name glory. So, God, we come. We come, God, as one people. We come, God, as one body, gathered in this, your sanctuary, asking, God, that you would meet each and every one of us at the very point of our need. God, we need you this day. And God, we need a word from you this day. God, a word that is going to carry us. A word, dear God, that is going to hold us. A word, dear God, that is going to transform us. God, do a new thing. And breathe your Holy Spirit in this place, God, like never before. God, blow a fresh wind in this place, God. That, God, lives will be forever changed. Have your way, God, like never before. Save souls, God. Comfort grieving hearts, God. Dry weeping eyes, God. And allow us to feel your presence and your power. Us so grateful as to give your name all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Jesus, you're the center of my joy.
To read our scripture this morning as you stand all over the church. Isn't it wonderful to know that Jesus is the center of our joy? Isn't it wonderful to know that Jesus is the hope for our lives? Isn't it wonderful to know? This morning, our scripture reading is coming from 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. And we're going to read it together because it is one verse. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7 reads, "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind." Amen. Praise the Lord. You may take your seats. Amen. This morning, we have a few announcements to make. On February 24th, 2024, there will be a prostate cancer seminar from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. We will not be doing a screening, amen. Prostate cancer seminar from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. here at the church, amen. And for the brothers in the house, Reverend Abraham Smith, if you can raise your hand. Amen. You all can see him to sign up if you have not already signed up for the seminar. For the seminar. February 25th, we will celebrate our Social Justice and HBCU Sunday. We are so grateful that the retired pastor, Reverend Lee P. Washington, will be our speaker. Amen. At 10 a.m. on next Sunday. Amen. And there are a few additional announcements that Pastor Folsom will come and lift, but we want you all to stay tuned because next month is Women's History Month. Amen. Women's Her Story Month. Amen. Amen. And following those announcements, we will dismiss our children for Children's Church, and our teenagers will be dismissed later in the service. Amen.
Amen. Give God a hand clap of praise. Come on, give him glory and give him honor. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, he brought me all week long. Somebody give God praise and somebody give God glory. We got an infant baptism today. Somebody give God praise and somebody give God glory. He woke us up this morning. That's just enough for me. Somebody give God praise and give him glory and give him honor. If that's your testimony, if you're feeling that God has done one thing for you, then give him praise and give him glory and give him honor. Tomorrow is never promised, but today we're going to celebrate the goodness of God. Somebody give God praise. Somebody give God glory. Somebody give him honor. I don't know who I'm talking to. God's trying to heal your body. God's trying to turn your life around. God's trying to do something in your family. Anybody giving praise this morning? Anybody want to just take time to say hallelujah? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Brother Patrick, hallelujah. For God is not finished with you yet. Somebody give God praise. Somebody give him glory and give him honor. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. All right, we're gonna play. We're gonna take your seats if you can. Hallelujah. We're coming back. We're coming back there, musicians. I believe the Holy Ghost is gonna bring that back. Brother Bill doing the sermon. I just think he'll bring it back. Hallelujah. I want to thank Sister Nadine, because she's on solo duty in the sound and audio visual. Give her a hand clap of praise. Listen, sometimes if the mic don't sound right, she'll get into it. Wait a minute. I saw one more hand. Come on, stand up. Oh, no, she ain't on solo duty. She got two or three people helping her. Give them a hand clap of praise. I got it. But Sister Nadine is like the engineer. She running everything up there. Amen? Amen, amen. I want to take a moment to, and I don't do this all the time, but I want to recognize our own Delegate Marvin Holmes. I know you come all the time. Stand up, because it's crucial that we have somebody in the General Assembly right here as member of Greater Mount Nebo. Thank you, sir. Thank you. We got to talk after service. Amen. Amen. I want to talk about this prostate cancer seminar. I want to talk about this prostate cancer seminar. Brother Battle, stand up, and Pastor Abraham Smith, stand up. Now listen, Brother Battle, it's this Saturday, February 24th, 10 a.m. to 12. Lunch will be provided. I want to be clear. It's open to men and women. Because brothers might not come, ladies, but you know them, so you get the information and take it back to them. Can I get a witness? It's free lunch. It's free lunch. Can I say free lunch?
Amen.
Come on. 10 to 12, and I'm going to give a short story about this. Last year, when I was at, maybe a couple years ago, when I was at Hemingway Memorial AME Church pastoring, Brother Battle came, but he did a different type presentation, but it was on prostate cancer. Now listen, we didn't have a huge turnout, but it's not about the number, but what happened was, after they gave all this information out and he showed this film, the men's minister at Hemingway had already done his physical for the year, and his numbers, Brother Warren, were okay, but he wasn't feeling good. And after he heard that presentation, he went back to the doctor. Said, my numbers look good, but I ain't feeling good. After they did further tests, he was in the early stages of prostate cancer. But did I say early stages? After a few treatments of radiation and prayer, come on, he's fully cured right now. Give God a hand clap of praise. I'm telling you, don't you miss it. I don't know. Listen, how can they? I know we got to get, almost said black folks. But we got to get us, Sister Mary Johnson. We're not going to answer to Eventbrite that often right now. We're going to get us to Eventbrite soon, electronic registration. But I need you to sign up. So if somebody out there can put a sheet of paper at the end, somewhere out there on some table that says prostate cancer, hallelujah, and people sign up, women and men, for this Saturday, 10 to 2, they need to know how much lunch to bring. Also, brothers, they want to meet with the men after service right here. So you can still sign up now once you get out. The paper will be out there. But you can still sign up, but meet with these two. They want to talk to you about the importance of trying to be here on Saturday. Or women, though, come on now. You know some guys ain't going to come. Go and sign up for them. Take the information back to them. God bless you. Give God a hand clap of praise. I'm going down my little list here, Sister Mary Johnson. Listen, the Farming Initiative. It is out one of them ways. I'm pointing the wrong way. The grant, I'm pointing the right way. There's a grant that we have been blessed to provide the land and a few other things that the Second Episcopal District will provide. But I was just thinking about my eating habits. So I was just as wrong when I stopped by that McDonald's drive-thru Friday, and I didn't get like a cheeseburger. Uh-oh. I went all the way double quarter pounder with cheese.
Uh-oh. Wait a minute.
Large fries, yeah. And I might want, ain't no need to plan off and top it off with a Diet Coke. Go on with the real one there. I'm saying all that not to make light of it. The initial things Brother Harry done for this garden is it's going to provide fresh produce. It's only an acre, a little over acre and a half. I call it a garden, because we had this bigger thing at Quitman George in our backyard. But it's going to start something, and it's free. All we're doing is providing the land and a few other things that we're going to talk about later, Brother Patrick, we'll talk about. But we ain't provided it. But all we're doing is providing the land, and I want to give you, I'll have to wait till the bishop gives me more. But it's not really we providing the land for free. We're not going to be really providing the land for free. You hear me? They're going to get, Come on, there's revenue from the land. All right? And so it's going to be intergenerational. It's going to be where all generations can meet together and do some things in gardening. I know when I was growing up, they made all of us, I didn't want to go, but they made all of us go out to the garden. One chance that Greater Mount Nebo is taking the lead. Everybody set up at that conference at mid-year when they heard we were taking the lead to provide the land to do something intergenerational. They're going to copy off of us. So come on now. We're going to get behind this initiative, and when we're going to get some other things, Brother Patrick, because guess what? If we have to use the water the land, I'm trying to help you out. Everything, we're going to get something from this. Come on, and it's going to stay here. Help you out. Listen, if they put another storage shed here to house the tools, the storage shed stays here. Everything, I'm trying to help you. If they just to help you, it's going to be a blessing. It's going to be a blessing. I need y'all to come on and join me and get behind it, because this is going to be a blessing to the Second Episcopal District. I'll say more about it in our church conference and everything when I get more details. But I know it's going to be a blessing. Amen. Give God a hand clap of praise. Y'all didn't clap on your blessing. Don't sleep on your blessing. We the only church. Uh-oh. Next Sunday, HBCU Sunday, what they do? Y'all wear your HBCU, whatever you normally do, come on, wear your HBCU shirts. If you went to a different type school, then find a way to wear that shirt too. But whatever. Sunday, and everybody came in. Come on, wear your paraphernalia or wear your high school, I don't know, wear your high school shirts or something. Come on in. Come on in. Come on, universities. But come like you need to come. Or if you don't want to wear nothing but what you got on or something like you got on today, just come. I just want you to come. Amen. Dr. Trulier called me. Days mixed up. I said, it happens. Yeah, I know for me, I can't go downstairs and remember what I was going down there for. Pastor Lee P. Washington, email Pastor Lee P. Washington. He said he'll be delighted. Pastor Emeritus of Reed Temple AME Church. He'll be preaching on Palm Sunday. I just got this confirmation this morning. On Palm Sunday, 10 o'clock, Presiding Elder Weaver is going to be our preacher. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. Come on, come on, come on. Come on. Y'all hang in there. Because maybe Easter might be a surprise too. Amen, 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 amen. But listen, sign up. Next Sunday. I'm going to have a sign up table, trustees, in the back, just a sign up table. If you want to be any part, join one of the choirs, whether you want to join the praise team, whether you have a musician, now listen to this one. Whether parents want to, however they sign children up. See, I already talked to Mika. Why, that's what you're going to do. I'm trying to come up to 2024. They say you don't do that anymore. But however some parents might want their children to sing, then sign them up. We'll get somebody to call you. Because after Easter, we want to do a whole new thing. Amen. We're going to bring back the children's choir. We're going to upgrade the praise team. We're going to come back into a whole lot of things. We're going to bring back children's church right after Easter. After Easter, the resurrection happens. Amen. Come on, come on, and give God a hand clap of praise. So we have sign-up sheets out so that people can do that. Amen? Amen. Did I do that right? With the children? She didn't make it go on. Y'all, I'm filibustered here. Brother Kenny Rogers, look. Ain't nobody, we ain't had but two things you could do as the children, three, YPD. And then we had the usher and the junior choir. All right? And I guess where I landed first, because they say you're going to do something. They said, get on up there. So all of us was up there. in the junior choir. Amen. And then some of us peeled off of the junior choir. We ain't have one other place to go to. I'm an usher. Amen. I stuck with the usher. Amen. I'd rather be a doorkeeper. Come on, somebody, in the house of the Lord. Amen. All right. Last thing I want you to know, you'll hear more. It'll be quarterly conference. Mark your calendars. March 7th. I think that's a Thursday. Right here in the sanctuary. It'll be the final one before annual conference. Amen. Amen. Give God praise. Give God glory. Give our honor. Reverend Tamika will come up and do the rest of this. And then we have infant baptism today. This is going to be good. This is going to be good. So stand up if you came for infant baptism, if you came to support. If infant baptism came for support. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you. We'll be right to that soon. We'll be right there soon. Last thing is, there was a young man that last Sunday, he sat right there. He had a Morehouse jacket on, and he talked. Joined the church. You know, he couldn't. I don't know if he could be here this Sunday, but he told me, Nicholas Young, he said, he's got his MD from Princeton. Not Howard, not Wesley. Me process. So I'm going to talk to him even further, but he got to join the church first. And so when he joined the church and he went to Morehouse, and so we look forward to Nick Young joining the church and seeing God baptized as a child. That's why I'm bringing up baptism. Give God a hand clap of praise. Come on, take this microphone from me and do these introductions.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Pastor actually has already done what I'm supposed to do, but all of our sanctuary, we ask that you please stand. And for those who are worshiping with us online, we want you to drop a message in the chat to say hello, and our worship team, virtual worship team, will all of our visitors in the house this morning. We are so very, very glad that you are here today. We are so glad that you are with some information for you all to peruse through. And we ask that you come again and worship with us. Thank you so very, very much. And Greater Mount Nebo family, we're gonna take a minute and a half to 2 minutes max and greet our visitors and each other, amen? As our musicians give us some greeting music, amen? Amen. Thank you.
praise the Lord. I gave y'all a little extra, Pastor.
Amen. 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 As you take your seats, to our wonderful family who has gathered for baptism, we ask that you please draw to come to the front now, please, and our stewardesses and our stewards, please. To the Lux family, our ministers, our stewards, and our stewardesses, we ask that you please come.
We are so happy to have this family for infant baptism. And they got, that's all right. He'll be okay. He'll be all right. I'm going to go ahead and let you say the baby's name right off the bat.
His name is Cairo Dogeobosalume Okoje Lux. Do you want to know what it means? Cairo means victorious one. Dogeobosalume means come and see what the Lord has done for me. Okoje means king, and Lux means light.
Amen, amen. So the first name is Cairo, right? Okay, all right. Amen, amen. Let us pay attention to the infant baptism. Dearly beloved, for as much as all persons are heirs of life, and everlasting subjects of saving grace of the Holy Spirit, and that our Lord Jesus Christ said, suffer little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven. I beseech you to call upon God the Father through our Lord Jesus Christ, that all of his bounteous goodness he will grant unto Kyra the constant and continual replenishment of his grace, that he become a good and worthy member of Christ's holy church. This is to the witnesses, to all of the witnesses, family witnesses that came to stand. Dearly beloved, for as much as this child is now presented by you for Christian baptism and is consecrated to God, to his church, it is your part and duty to see that he be taught as soon as he shall be able to learn the meaning and purpose of the Holy Sacrament, that he shall be trained to give regular and faithful attendance upon the public and private worship of God and the teaching of the Holy Scripture, and that in every way, by precept and example, you will seek to lead him into the love of God and the service of our Lord Christ. Here's the question. Well, let me say it this way. I said all of those words, Sister Drusilla, to say this. As a witness before God, he may not understand it all now, but it's our job and your job as standing here to live an exemplary life in front of him so that he will grow up and he will stay with the Lord, and that he will continue to love the Lord thy God. And so when we stand with the family, you are witnesses, and you have, and God has, and you have agreed by God to be a witness all of your life of what God can be to this young man. That's what this means. So we don't take this lightly, that we've just been asked to stand. We've been asked for a purpose. I'm going to ask you this question. Do you solemnly promise to fulfill these duties as so far as in you lies, the Lord being your helper? Please say, we do. Amen. I got the we do from everybody. I'm going to turn it over to our youth minister, Reverend Tamika McFadden.
Hear the words of the gospel written in Mark chapter 10, beginning at the 13th verse. And it reads this way, and they were bringing children to him, him being Jesus, that he might touch them. And the disciples rebuked them. But when Jesus saw it, he was indignant and said to them, let the children come to me. Do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of God. Truly I say to you, whosoever doesn't receive the kingdom of God like a child shall not enter in it. And he took them in his arms and blessed them, laying his hands upon them.
All right. He don't want to leave mama, but that's okay. We're going to make this work. Okay, daddy got him now. Kyra, I baptize you. You can do the water.
Name the child one more time.
Name the child.
Yeah. Kyra, Doge Voselume, Okoje Lux.
Kyra. I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. He made it. He made it, and he did really good. He did really good. He did really good. If we can, hallelujah. Amen. He said a high five. Dad said a high five. Let us turn and face the church, if we could turn and face the church and repeat the Lord's Prayer.
Let us pray the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. And to the Lux family, I present you Cairo's certificate of baptism, signed by Pastor Folsom.
Give God praise. Give God glory. They just told me his uncle was baptized in this church in 1990. Give God praise and give God glory and give him honor. Hallelujah. I want to thank you to our stewards. I want to thank you to the ministerial staff for coming and standing with us. God bless you. God bless you. Well, let me do it down here. I don't have to go up there. It's time for the offering. It's time to give. It's time to give. It's time to give. It's time to give. So, stewards, I shouldn't ask you to sit down. The two baskets, come on back. Put the two baskets up. Listen, God has already spoken to you about financial giving. I don't need to do a lot of preaching about that. I just need to ask you to open your ears and listen to what God says. Some of y'all, he told you to give above the tithe. Some of you told you to give the tithe. Listen to me. And some of you, he told you to give what you have. And some of you may not have it this time, but you may be able to come around, touch the basket, and believe next time God is going to do something in your life. Some people give online. They'll put that on the screen. We have Easy Tithe. We have Cash App. So some, and we have, you can go on the website and give. They'll be putting that up on the screen during the offering. But whatever we do, do what God told you to do, and God will bless you for it. Amen? We'll follow the directions of our ushers. Thank you so much.
right. Hallelujah. Listen, we praise God for the instruments. Amen. Come on, let's pray. God, we thank you. We thank you for these gifts, these financial gifts, God, these talents, God. We thank you, dear God, for the love that you have given through these gifts, God, given us to give. God, we pray that these financial gifts, God, go to the upbuilding of your kingdom called Greater Mount Nebo, God, here for this body, dear God, so that we can do the work that you have called our hands to do. So, God, we thank you. We thank you for the gift. We thank you for the giving. Now, God, continue to bless and continue to add the increase. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Now we will have our praise team and our musicians come again for our sermonic selection. Amen. And our teenagers are dismissed for teen church. Amen.
Awesome. You are so awesome to me.
Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. He's still holy. Holiness is still good. Holiness is still of God. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise and give him glory and give him honor. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't go too far, musicians. Don't go too far. Amen. Amen. If you have your Bibles or your Bible apps, turn with me. Whatever you may be using, John, the third chapter, first through the eighth verse, John 3, 1 through 8. I have the Message Bible. John 3, that was our infant baptism person let me know that he had turned to the page in the Bible. John 3, verses 1 through 8. The Message Bible says it this way. There was a man of the Pharisee sect, Nicodemus, a promised leader among the Jews. Late one night he visited Jesus and said, "Rabbi, we all know you're a teacher straight from God. No one could do all the God-pointing, the God-revealing acts you do if God were not in on it." Jesus said, "You're absolutely right. Take it from me. Unless a person is born from above or born again, it is not possible to see what I'm pointing to God's kingdom." Verse 4, "How can anyone," said Nicodemus, "be born who has already been born and grown up? You can't re-enter your mother's womb and be born again. What are you saying with this born from above or born again talk?" Jesus said, "You're not listening. Let me say it again. Unless a person submits to this original creation," I like this version, "the wind hovering over the water creation," go back to Genesis, "the invisible moving the visible, a baptism into a new life, is not possible to enter God's kingdom. When you look at a baby, it's just that, a body you can look at and touch, but the person who takes shape within is formed by something you can't see and touch, the spirit, and becomes a living spirit. So don't be surprised when I tell you that you have to be born from above, out of this world, so to speak. You know well enough how the wind blows this way and that. You hear it rustling through the trees, but you have no idea where it comes from or where it's headed next. That's the way it is with everyone born from above, by the wind of God, the Spirit of God." Pray with me as we get started. This is our year of revival. The sermon series we're on is My Power Out Again? Sermon title, A Walk Through the Gospel of John. Today's title is The Wind of God. And our remix title, Together We Can Make It. Pray with me as we get started. God, in the name of Jesus, move Gerald out of the way. Let the real teacher teach. Let the Holy Spirit do it. God, we thank you and we praise you. Open hearts, open minds. God, we're praying that you, something said or something that happened during this service, during this worship experience, somebody will be saved. whether online or in person, somebody will be set free, delivered, or healed. Someone will grow. Someone may even want to designate this as their home church. But whatever you do, we turn it over to you. Do it right now in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Is my power out again? Is my power out again? The wind of God. I know that you all, we were expecting, according to Doug Kramer and the rest of them, on the weather station, on all the weather. You know how they play up the weather? And you know, if it's coming towards Sunday, all of us pastors go into deep prayer. Well, Doug Kramer said, I predicted 3 to 5 inches early, Sister Ruth. And then 11 o'clock, when everybody was not really paying attention, he dropped it to 1 to 3. And then when you woke up, it wasn't nothing. I was honored, and Sister Mary Fulton was on the committee, and I was honored to be a part of the 43rd annual African-American or Black History Month breakfast at Martin's Crosswind. I had to say the benediction, so I had to stay all the way through the program. Amen. To say the benediction, but it was put on by Representative Steny Hoyer and Representative Glenn Ivey. And so I was honored to be there for that. But the winds begin to blow. Y'all heard the winds? And when it blows, I don't know about in your neighborhood, but when it blows in mine, the first thing that comes to my mind is my power gonna go out again. Well, Nicodemus was wrestling with this physical birth. And let me tell you, Pastor Abraham, when I was born, come on, y'all know where, Quitman, Georgia. I'm going to keep saying that till y'all get down to Quitman, Georgia. Two traffic lights, same amount of people that was there when I was born. My mother, Sister Mary Johnson, carried me in overtime. I was supposed to come out a day or so early. But it was so good. In the warmness, I didn't want to come out. And they took her into the hospital on a Tuesday. I wasn't born until Thursday. Is my power out again? It wasn't born until Thursday. It was a hard birth for her. She bore scars for a long time after that birth. Supposed to come on Tuesday, didn't come to Thursday. Carried me into overtime. And I'm so glad that her power didn't go out, that she hung in there. Because overtime wasn't the best time. Brother Bill, let me tell you about overtime. Even when I came out, Reverend Peck, even when I came out, this is what they told me, 8:31 a.m. on a Thursday, July 26, 1962. Even when I came out, it wasn't no noise. So back in those days, I don't know what they do now. The doctor slapped you on your butt once, they still didn't get nothing. Twice, nothing. I told y'all I was having a good time. But on the third spank, the cry, just as Carol just did, said there was new life coming into the world. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise for new life coming into the world. And for that long time, Sister Ruth, now I understand. My mother's gone home to be with the Lord, Sister Alzina. I just got to tell this. I understand now. She carried me in her arms. I was her firstborn. Now my sister came right out hollering. Amen. 7 years later. She carried me everywhere. Even when I was supposed to be walking, I just, you know, I was comfortable not coming out. I was comfortable her carrying me. She took me to all kinds of specialists. They say nothing wrong with him. He's just gonna be lazy. Me, Sister Felicia, I thank God that her power didn't go out, because she carried me until one day, and she really didn't have to carry me. You know, I figured out in my mind, I think I was a little halfway smarter than I was, you know, early on. I said, but they want to carry me. That I don't have to walk from room to right. They can carry me over there. They can carry me. I think that's why First Lady, if we could afford it, I would love limousine service every day. Have somebody carry you. But here we go on the serious note. I'll just finish this up and get to the real sermon. What happened was, Sister Mary Johnson, they took us over to a person's house in Quitman, Georgia. And Sister Ruth, they tell me now, you know, I wasn't old enough to understand. They tell me. The person, hadn't cleaned up in a long time. The house was a little untidy. And they got ready to put me down, just like this right here. They say my legs just hit the floor, bam, and began walking. My power came on. Somebody give God praise, because point number one, your power didn't go out in my mama. And the power didn't go out in this wind that happened yesterday. And the power at your house stayed on. And the power at this church stayed on. There was earlier this week where something happened and this power surged. It took the phones out. It took the internet connection out. But thanks be to God, the power came on again. Because look, the signs are up. The internet is up. The phones are working. Give God praise, because the power, it's still going on. Point number one. It's good to meet Jesus in the midnight hour. The Bible says there was a man of the Pharisee sect, Nicodemus, a prominent leader among the Jews, and late one night he visited Jesus and said, Rabbi, we know you're a good teacher, straight from God. No one can do all this God-pointing, God-revealing acts that you do if God weren't in on it. The Pharisees were a group of conservative Jews devoted to keeping the law in those times. They were devoted to keeping the law. You ain't and they added to it when they wanted to. In other words, it may say this, but then since they were in that sect, they added whatever they wanted to. Come on, I'm teaching this. They were the Oxford Dictionary says that the Pharisees were members of an ancient Jewish sect distinguished by strict observance of the traditional and written law. It had to be written, and it was in the tradition of the day. And they didn't move past that. And they commonly held pretensions that they were superior to everyone else. So the Pharisees walked in a way that was carried themselves that they were over everybody else. Y'all know they gave Jesus problems. But one of them, Nicodemus, he was a Pharisee. One of them approached Jesus late one night. Why at night? Nicodemus, the scripture said, he thought well of Jesus. He knew he was a teacher from God. He said that because only he could perform the signs, the wonders and miracles. So why did he creep to Jesus at night? You know why? Most of his colleagues didn't feel the same way about Jesus, but Nicodemus went to Jesus under the cover of darkness so his colleagues wouldn't rebuke him. So then Nicodemus didn't want to admit his love and admiration for Jesus during the daytime, but he did steal away to him at night. And perhaps, the scripture doesn't tell you, but you can use your imagination, perhaps Nicodemus came by night because he was a little timid. You know, perhaps it's quiet in the midnight hour, and Nicodemus came. Perhaps Nicodemus wanted some uninterrupted time with Jesus. And I came by this morning, to let you know it could be various reasons why Nicodemus came during night to Jesus. Even in our lives, we try and I try to control our own situations instead of turning them over to God. And sometimes when things don't work out, you and I have tried all that we can do. Just when it looks like the clock is about to run out, just when it looks like things are not going to get any better, somewhere in the midnight hour, yes, late in the midnight hour, God begins to turn our situations around. God begins to turn our burdens around. God begins to relieve us from some of our stress and anxieties. And God begins to change our thoughts. And every now and then in the midnight hour, we can get interrupted with an interview with Jesus. I want some uninterrupted time with Jesus. And when we get uninterrupted time with Jesus, Jesus has a way of grabbing our situations. Jesus has a way of grabbing our circumstances. Jesus has a way of taking our anxieties and pushing them to the side. Jesus has a way of turning things around. Jesus has a way of moving it and doing what the song says, late in the midnight hour. He's going to turn it. You think that every now and then we got to fall on our knees. Every now and then our knees may not be enough. Sometimes we have to fall on our face. So here I answer by and by. In the late to you, when you have that talk with Jesus, he'll turn your situation around. Turn to your neighbor, say, neighbor, is my power out again? Turn to the other neighbor and say, neighbor, late in the midnight hour, I had a talk with Jesus. Turn to the other neighbor, say, neighbor, together we can make it. Hey, neighbor, late in the midnight hour, you'll turn it around. You'll turn it around. You'll turn it around. Stewards and my ministers, stand on your feet real quick. Stewards and all my ministers, stand on your feet. Late in the midnight hour. Hey, in the midnight hour, I want to stretch my hands. Situations going to come up. Things going to happen. Things that don't look like they used to be. And we all trying to hear from God to figure this out. But I guarantee you, in the midnight hour, I pray that God speaks to you in an uninterrupted time. God's will is for your praise. Y'all can take your seats. Point number two, you must be born again. You must be born again. Must be born again. I'm almost done. Jesus said in verse 3 of John, the third chapter, Sister Ruth, you're absolutely right. Take it from me, unless a person is born from above, it's not possible to see what I'm pointing to, or born again. He was always pointing to God's kingdom. You remember when Jesus came? He said, the kingdom of God is at hand. Seek ye first. What did he say? And all of his. Come on now. And so Jesus was never pointing to himself. He was always pointing to the kingdom of God. That's why I keep saying Jesus was never self-centered. He was always others-centered. And so Nicodemus had just paid Jesus a compliment. And he told him, say, I know you're a teacher, and you do all these signs and wonders. And Jesus didn't even smile. He didn't even beat around the bush. He said, now look, Nicodemus, unless a person is born from above, it's not possible to see what I'm pointing to. You can talk, but you can't see it. In other verses, it says, unless someone is born again, he or she cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus Pharisee, religious leader, with all of his education, with all of his authority, with all of his power, could only understand the physical birth that I talked about with my mother. He had no idea what Jesus was talking about in the spiritual birth. Jesus clearly said that without this, unless one is born again, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. What he was telling Nicodemus is, all you can be morally good. You hear people say, I'm good, I'm just morally good. You can be morally good. You can be religious. Mm-hmm. But that's what Jesus was talking about. Jesus said, one must be born again. Jesus stuck to that. This isn't something Jesus was really saying that you can do for yourself. He wanted Nicodemus to understand that entering into the kingdom required an individual to be spiritually reborn. In other words, Nicodemus needed a spiritual rebirth. Simply being a religious leader wouldn't cut it. Simply having a title won't get it. Simply having been in church forever just won't get it. Nicodemus said, you must be born again. My grandmother knows. I'm going to talk to the generations online. The younger generation, you may not understand it. I don't understand. My grandmother knows, with no education, understood. You must be born again. But maybe they didn't understand it. Not too long ago, Sister Margaret Rose, I was walking over in, I'm going to say where I was walking at. It was a public place. And I don't know why God does me like this, and maybe he does some of you like this. I was just walking, minding my business. And God said, stop those three people and ask them they know Jesus. Now I got a choice. I can listen to God. I can go on about my business. God and go about our own business. Too bogged down on something else. Can I go on and testify? That I have heard him and went about my business. This time. So I want to encourage some people that have heard God but haven't acted yet. Hang in there. This time I heard him and I began to discuss him with three people. What they tried to tell me, Sister Drusilla, all three, when I asked them about it, they said, well, you know, my family is a member of, come on, now Nicodemus' story is coming alive. They tried to talk about what church their family was a member of. That's not what we was talking about. Reverend Ellis. They told me about the church membership that they had. I wasn't asking them about church membership. I was asking them, had they been born again. And I was explaining to them, they listen, you know when this was, so I'm telling when it was. They told me they just got the ashes on the forehead. I said, I wasn't asking you about that. I'm asking you, have you been born again? I had to let them know all these things are good and noble, but Jesus required one thing. We must be. There's something amazing about the born-again experience. In the born-again experience, Brother Harry Dunn, you really have the power of the living God. You can feel it on the inside of you. When you get this born-again experience, you really understand when the scriptures say blinded eyes really can't be opened again. When you get this born-again experience, you can really believe that the lame will begin to walk again. When you get this born-again experience, you believe that the mute, the ones that have been silent all their life, will talk again. now I'm found. I see. But this is one I like. 'Twas grace that taught my heart. Just did that grace appear. The hour I found. Hour that you're first relieved. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, wake up. We gonna make it. We gonna make it. Point number three, and we done. We'd have been done early if the musicians had to picked up that little. Final point. Serious point. Of God. W-I-N-D. The wind of God. I see you looking at me. Scripture says. Says, so don't be surprised when I tell you this world, so to speak. You know well enough how the wind blows this way and that. You hear it rustling through the trees, but you have no idea where it comes from or where it's headed. That's the way it is with everybody born again, by the wind of God, by the wind of God, the Spirit of God. Nicodemus, he was a religious leader confused. Jesus kept saying, you're not listening to me. You're not listening to me. I try to emulate Jesus as much as I can. When I might not have full understanding, but I got to stick in there with the people. Understand it or not. And so this is a part of communication that brings on womb for a second birth. Jesus began speaking spiritually and told him that, yes, that's the physical birth. And the spirit. But the person who has the grounds are just insufficient. You must be experience spiritual life is to be born of the Spirit. Tell me more about that, Pastor. Make it plain. Let me tell you about the Spirit. It's like the wind. You hear the wind, but you don't see the wind. There's a spirit. You know it's there. You don't see it. You can't control the wind. All you can do is see the effects of the wind. Trees down. Power lines down. Power goes out. You can't control the wind. All you can do is see the effects. It's the same way with being born of the Spirit. God's Spirit, the wind of God, invisibly does its work on the inside of the human heart. We can't see it happening on our inside, but it's working on us. However, when the wind of God begins to work on us, all we can see is the results. As the Spirit of God begins to knock down the barriers. The Spirit of God begins to pick up where we've fallen down. The Spirit of God begins to restore the power to us by the blood of Jesus. On this Founders Month, the wind of God did it for Richard and Sarah Allen. And the wind of God did it for your grandmamas and granddaddies. And the wind of God did it for your mama and your daddy. But the wind of God is here to do it for you. I don't care what you've been struggling with today. I don't care if you don't even understand it. The wind of God will turn it around.
around. Talk to me, CC Winers. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy has never failed me. All my days I've been and held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of the Lord. Talk to me, hymnist. All to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him. In his presence daily live. All to Jesus, humbly at his feet I bow. Worldly pleasures all forsaken. Take me, Jesus, take me now. I surrender all, I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. The wind will knock down the barriers. The wind will knock down the financial barriers. The wind will knock down relationship barriers. But God will build them back up. Is your power out again? It's not out again. Why? Because you must be born again. Somebody say yeah. Say yes. Say yes. You must be born again. While you're at your seats, bow your heads, close your eyes. I'm gonna do a little different today. May take just a little while long. Y'all bear with me. I'm gonna start the call off like this. This is for everybody under the sound of my voice, and if you're online, you can join us too. If you've been struggling with anything in your life, come on, let's break through directly. If you got a new pastor in the middle of the year, if you've been struggling, it's okay. The time of struggle brings growth. We just have to bring it to the Lord in prayer. We all gonna struggle, Sister Ruth. I struggle. First lady struggle. When there's newness and we meet each other for the first time and we have not been built a relationship and it takes time, there's gonna be struggle. If you've been struggling and you're online too, it's nothing wrong with that. Struggle breeds growth. Growth shows understanding. The best place to take it is to the Lord in prayer. Don't take it out to the parking lot. Come on, come on. If that's you, the altar is open. I'm gonna start that call. It's a little different call the way it happened. If you've been struggling, not just with church, anything in your life that you're struggling with, the altar is open. The altar is open. Come, 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 come. You don't worry about your neighbor. Now I know, I'm gonna say it this way. It's more than it should come to the altar. You know y'all been struggling with my style. Come on, take it to God. He's the only one that can change it and turn it around. You've been struggling, that's my ministers too, come on. Everybody, la-di-da-di. And everybody, the place to bring it is to the altar. Ask God. Show you how he wants you to proceed. Show your space. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on. The altar is open just for you. If you've been struggling a little bit, this time is for you. No condemnation. There is no condemnation in Christ Jesus. You've just been struggling.
while they're at the altar and they're enjoying their time with the Lord, is there one person who would like to give their life to Christ? In other words, be born again. If that's you, put a one online. But if you're in the sanctuary and you want to give Jesus a try, maybe another try, raise your right hand, raise your right hand. If you're in the sanctuary, raise your right hand. Is there one that needs to know him? Second call. If you like a church home, we'd love for Greater Mount Nebo to be your virtual online, we'll take you. Put a two. But someone God may be telling today, join this church, grow with this church. If that's you, raise your right hand. Is there anyone? Raise your right hand. Raise your right hand. Raise your right hand. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, Shanda Bosa. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is there one? If you raised your hand, I couldn't see everywhere. We ask you to stand on your feet if you raised your hand for one of those two calls. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
So good.
I know he didn't raise your hand. I just want to pray with you after service.
I will sing
after service. Amen. I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you. Hallelujah. All right. The altar is not closed after service. And First Lady, can you do me a favor? Can you go down and stand at the door? I'm gonna join you at the door, but I got to pray for this one person beforehand. She's gonna go now.
I will sing.
If after service you still needed to come to the altar and just let whatever the struggle is, turn it over to God. That's the only person I know can answer. And he'll work it out. He'll work it out. Sister Margaret Rowe. We on our way to something great. Turk. That's what we say, Greater Mount Nebo. This is just a little struggling time. Sister Felicia, it's just a little struggling time. Y'all know the plan, storming, norming, reform. You know the process. God's not going to let us skip a process. But we're going to make it through love in this thing together. We're going to make it, Brother Bill, through love together. Amen. Amen. I'm so glad that you're well again from COVID. Give God a hand clap of praise for healing. Come on, stand on your feet. We're going home. If you want to have prayer, I want to pray with you too before I get to the door. And our First Lady going to shake up most of y'all hands, but I'm going to get this couple of pray with them, and then I'm going to rush right out there. Amen. Brother Hines, come here for a minute.
With every breath that I am able,
come on, y'all. Give God a hand clap of praise for Brother Hines. I just wanted to stand up here with him. I want his daughter to see him. As daughter, I'm the county executive's faith community's liaison, and I was down there at the county building. The daughter said, "I heard your Bible study last night," and I said, "Huh?" And she said, "My dad had it on." Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. Brother Hines and Antoine, stay with me while we do this. Now to may the grace of God, sweet communion of the Holy Ghost, may it rest, rule, and abide with you. In other words, may he continue to walk with you. May he continue to talk with you. May he continue to be with you. May he continue to love upon you. May you continue to hear the wind blow and know that with him, your power will never go out. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say, amen. God praise. Men, give God glory. Men, we need to see you over here to my left. And also, come back HBCU Sunday. Don't y'all leave me here. Pack this place up for Pastor Lee P. Washington. I already told him we're going to pack it out. So go on, tell some folks. Come on back next Sunday. Amen. God bless you. God bless. Come on up and let's get a, did we get a picture? Come on, get a picture. We'll get a picture after. We're going to get a picture. I need those two right here. If you just, I want to pray with you, that's all. Come up, come on up. God bless you all. God bless you. Men, don't forget to come on over. Brother Anthony Gray. And family, come on up here.